Do you like teaching? Have you thought about becoming a teacher with a PhD in STEM? In this video, I'll talk about how I explored various teaching opportunities and share with you some tips to help you decide whether teaching is a good fit for you. Welcome to my YouTube channel, my name is Zhu. I'm a PhD in neuroscience turned machine learning engineer. I have been a professional student since I went to kindergarten at age 3, and I have met a lot of great teachers and mentors who not only taught me knowledge, but also inspired and influenced my life. Growing up in China, we highly respect teachers to the point that if you ask kids what they want to become when they grow up, a lot of them would probably say a teacher. So it is pretty natural for me to consider teaching as their career path. There are 3 types of teaching positions in higher education. They're different by the amount of teaching and research responsibility. The first type is research professors in the traditional academia career path. They tend to have little to none teaching responsibility, and their primary responsibility is research, also known as applying for research grants and published papers. Assistant or associate professors are usually required to teach several courses before they get their tenure. Although teaching is not a big part of being a research professor, mentoring is. Research professors are expected to provide mentorship to their students and postdocs, both on academic research and on personal development. In my opinion, there's a huge gap between PhD education and being a good mentor. I've heard a lot of stories from my friends and peers about how they were unfairly treated by their PhD advisor and how much they wish their advisor could give them more guidance on career development. The second type of teaching position is teaching professors. As the name suggests, their primary responsibility is teaching, while they could still spend some of their time doing research and applying for grants. Compared to research professors, teaching professors are usually not evaluated by the amount of paper they publish. At first, it may seem that life as a teaching professor may be less intense than research professors, since they do not have the publish or perish work style. However, they may notice it's not easy to find time and resource for their research projects when the teaching duty is heavy. I have talked with one alumnus from my department who was working as a teaching professor. According to him, a lot of these teaching professor positions were not in top-tiered university, and it was not easy to apply for research grants or recruit students for his projects. So sometimes he had to do all his experiments by himself at night after a long day of teaching. The third type of teaching position is lecturers. They usually don't have any research responsibility at all, and they are completely evaluated by their teaching. Among these 3 types of teaching positions, the first 2 would still require some academic publications, while the 3rd one mostly focuses on teaching skills. Since I didn't have anything as papers yet, I reduced my choice to becoming a lecturer. I have talked with some alumni from my department who became teachers in college, teaching undergraduate or graduate courses. Some became teachers in high school, teaching natural science. So in short, teaching was definitely a possible career path for PhDs. But was it a good fit for me? As far as I remember, my very first teaching experience was when I was in high school. During summer break, I was tutoring my young cousin and neighbors. I don't remember exactly what I was teaching, but I do remember I got impatient and frustrated very quickly. I remember after the first and only tutoring session, I was telling my mom, "I don't know why they just can't get it. It is literally written on the textbook." Of course, it is not because they were not smart. It is because I didn't know how to teach and share what I knew to others at that time. I learned very early in my life that just because you're good at learning doesn't mean you'll be good at teaching. I started to become interested in teaching during college, and I volunteered to be a TA for an undergraduate biology course. At that time, by the school rules, only graduate students could be TA. So I wrote an email to the professor and asked to be an informal TA, assisting the official TA and the professor. I told him that I took this course when I was a freshman, audited again when I was a sophomore, and I was very interested in this subject and wanted to contribute to this course. The professor happily accepted my application. During my informal TA experience, I organized discussion and Q&A sessions and gradually learned how to share my knowledge patiently and tailored to different learning styles. In my PhD program, every PhD student was required to work as a TA for 2 semesters. I TA'd for a graduate biology course, organizing bi-weekly recitations and helping students with their assignments. The recitations were optional, and in the first recitation, only 5 out of the 20 students showed up. I was disappointed by this low attendance, having spent days preparing the study materials for the recitation. Overall, during this course, I felt my time and effort was not well received. I came to realize this is also part of being a teacher. Sometimes you just don't get the appreciation you expect. Going through this experience also made me respect teacher and teaching even more. And then there's tutoring and online education. I've heard some PhD students did tutoring at the said gig to get extra cash for high school or undergraduate students. Some of them made considerable amount of money. I've also heard some PhD students work with online education companies to develop syllabus and class materials. Khan Academy is such a good example in the new era of teaching. So is Coursera and Udacity. As far as I know, Udacity offers this mentorship program and pays mentors to teach their students. Personally, I never did tutoring or online teaching myself, simply because I never got the time. In addition to TA experience, I attended several teaching training programs and workshops. The Columbia Center for Teaching and Learning provides an array of workshops and training programs to help graduate students improve their teaching skills. I applied one program called the Innovative Teaching Summer Institute in 2015. It is a 4-day collaborative workshop talking about different teaching technologies and practices. I got to work with peers from other departments and learn about all the amazing resources provided by CTL. CTL also offers the lead teaching fellowships for graduate students to organize teaching events in their home departments. I personally knew the 2 lead teaching fellows in my department. One of them later became a life science consultant, and the other one became a postdoc and continued doing research. In the lab, I supervised and mentored undergraduate and graduate students, helped them scope and define their projects, teach them how to do experiments, and give them some career advice. Personally, I find the one-on-one mentoring more rewarding and flexible than the one-to-many classroom teaching. And I really enjoy watching my mentee grow and help them achieve their goals. Another career path that has some similarity to teaching is science outreach. Throughout my PhD, I participated in several science outreach events organized by student groups and alumni, such as Girl Science Day and BioBus. It was very exciting to encourage the younger generation to become interested in science and technology. In order to accumulate more teaching experience outside university, I cold emailed a nonprofit arts education organization and volunteered to help teach art classes in New York public school. It was very fun to interact with kids, help them make artwork and see their improvement. At some point during my PhD, I even considered science education in the Natural History Museum and actually submitted an application, but never heard back. As you can tell from my stories, I explored various teaching opportunities. Over time, I came to realize that while I enjoyed sharing knowledge with others, I wasn't ready to teach for a living. First, teaching is such a huge responsibility. A good teacher can be inspiring and change a person's life in a positive way, and a bad teacher can really ruin a person's life, both emotionally and socially. Students look up to their teacher both for knowledge and for role models. I felt I was not ready for such a big responsibility. Second, I've always been more interested in learning than teaching. I like experimenting and exploring, and felt bored if I presented or taught the same content over and over again. Third, and probably most importantly, the salary for teachers is not appealing, especially if you teach at a public school in the United States. In my opinion, teachers are severely underpaid given their huge responsibility and challenges. So I crossed out teaching from my list. If you are also interested in teaching or want to find out whether teaching is a good fit for you, here are 3 tips. 1, just do it. Become a TA, even an informal one like the one I did as undergrad. Apply to be a volunteer teacher at your local schools. mentor undergraduate student in your lab, tutor your relatives or neighbors, apply for mentorship program in online education. There are a lot of teaching opportunities available. You can find links to some opportunities in the description below. In short, the more you teach, the better you will know whether you want to pursue teaching as a career. 2. Take advantage of resources offered by your PhD program. Attend workshop and career panels. Apply for teaching fellowships. Talk with career counselors. Participate in teaching training program and learn how to build your teaching portfolio. If you couldn't find such resources in your PhD program, try to look for resources online about how to prepare to be a teacher. 3. Talk with teachers. Reach out to your friends or alumni who are currently working as teachers and ask them what their job is like. Or simply talk to your own teachers. You may find out that teaching in action can be very different from what you thought. And again, being good at learning does not necessarily mean you'll be good at teaching. As for myself, although I may not become a professional teacher, I do enjoy sharing knowledge with others and learning from others. Learning and teaching are reciprocal, and I hope my YouTube video is helpful to you. It is certainly helpful to me to reflect on my experience and learn how to become a YouTuber. On a separate note, I plan to interview some friends from different career paths and talk about their work. Click the subscribe button below and stay tuned. In the next video, I'll be talking about my second non-academia career exploration, consulting. See you next time.